Blackstone Audio and Skyboat Media present The Forsaken Inn, a novel by Anna Katharine Green. This book is read by Gabrielle de Cuir.
Chapter 1. The Oak Parlor. I was riding between Albany and Poughkeepsie. It was raining furiously, and my horse, already weary with long travel, gave unmistakable signs of discouragement. I was therefore greatly relieved when, in the most desolate part of the road, I espied rising before me the dim outlines of a house, and was correspondingly disappointed when, upon riding forward, I perceived that it was but a deserted ruin I was approaching, whose fallen chimneys and broken windows betrayed a dilapidation so great that I could scarcely hope to find so much as a temporary shelter therein. Nevertheless, I was so tired of the biting storm that I involuntarily stopped before the decayed and forbidding structure, and was, in truth, withdrawing my foot from the stirrup when I heard an unexpected exclamation behind me, and turning, saw a chaise, from the open front of which leaned a gentleman of most attractive appearance. "What are you going to do?" he asked. "Hide my head from the storm," was my hurried rejoinder. "I am tired, and so is my horse, and the town, according to all appearances, must be at least 2 miles distant. No matter if it is 3 miles, you must not take shelter in that charnel house," he muttered, and moved along in his seat as if to show me there was room beside him. "Why," I exclaimed, struck with sudden curiosity, "is this one of the haunted houses we hear of? If so, I shall certainly enter, and be much obliged to the storm for driving me into so interesting a spot." I thought he looked embarrassed. At all events, I am sure he hesitated for a moment whether or not to ride on and leave me to my fate. But his better impulses seemed to prevail, for he suddenly cried, "Get in with me and leave mysteries alone. If you want to come back here after you have learned the history of that house, you can do so. But first ride on to town and have a good meal. Your horse will follow easily enough after he is rid of your weight." It was too tempting an offer to be refused. So, thankfully accepting his kindness, I alighted from my horse, and after tying him to the back of the chaise, got in with this genial stranger. As I did so, I caught another view of the ruin I had been so near entering. "Good gracious," I exclaimed, pointing to the structure that, with its projecting upper story and ghastly apertures, presented a most suggestive appearance, "if it does not look like a skull." My companion shrugged his shoulders but did not reply. The comparison was evidently not a new one to him. That evening, in a comfortable inn parlor, I read the following manuscript. It was placed in my hands by this kindly stranger, who in so doing explained that it had been written by the last occupant of the old inn I was so nearly on the point of investigating. She had been its former landlady, and had clung to the ancient house long after decay had settled upon its doorstep and desolation breathed from its gaping windows. She died in its north room, and from under her pillow the discolored leaves were taken, the words of which I now place before you.
January 28, 1775. I do not understand myself. I do not understand my doubts, nor can I analyze my fears. When I saw the carriage drive off, followed by the wagon with its inexplicable big box, I thought I should certainly regain my former serenity. But I am more uneasy than ever. I cannot rest. I keep going over and over in my mind the few words that passed between us in their short stay, under my roof. It is her face that haunts me. It must be that, for it had a strange look of trouble in it, as well as sickness. But neither can I forget his, so fair, so merry, and yet so unpleasant, especially when he glanced at her, and, as I could not help but think before they went away, when he glanced at me. I do not like him, and the chills creep over me whenever I remember his laugh.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.